Lastings Milledge here, former first-round draft pick out of Lakewood Ranch, Florida. I'm here at first-round training to kind of give you guys the translation of the Chris Carpenter 30 for 30. A lot of things get misconstrued in translations. Big leaguers understand big leaguers through translation. So when you guys see that on 30 for 30, now you try to relay that to your kid, and it might be some lost translation in there. So I'm going to give like the dummy-down version of what these guys are really trying to give you. Because we all think as parents that you have the translation down and you know exactly what they're talking about, but let me tell you, it's a lot of things that you would miss that'll be essential to your kids. So let me explain exactly, you know, what he's talking about. And so I'm not gonna make you feel, you know, like you don't know what you're talking about, but this is another outlet for you to get the right translation so you can get it to your kids and make sure that they're, you know, that they're working on their craft the right way. So we're gonna start out here with what he was talking about, what got him in trouble last year, okay? I looked at the video, and let me tell you, when I retired, I really didn't follow that much baseball here in the last decade, and I'm not even gonna lie to you, but once a big leaguer, always a big leaguer. What it takes to get to the big leagues, it never changed. So what he's talking about, okay, is what got him in trouble. Okay, what got him in trouble? This is what he said, and I don't follow him like that. Played against him, know the guy, great guy. But he said what happened to him where he got caught in the launch angle, and that's another thing that is a mistranslation too, with launch angle and things like that. But that's another video for another time. We're gonna try to keep it nice and sweet. He said that he got caught up into pulling the baseball, and Chris is from the left side, so let's get on the left side here. I'm not a good left-handed swinger, so I am not going to swing left-handed, but I'm going to give you the view of a lefty, okay? So what he said, again, he said that this part of the plate, the inside part of the plate, is what started to get him in trouble, because he started to wanting to hunt those pitches, okay? And when he first got to the big leagues, that wasn't him, okay? We know, like I said, we know we start following the launch angle, the numbers, the fly balls versus ground balls, things like that. So a lot of things have been playing with a lot of big leaguers and a lot of youth athletes across the world with this new launch angle thing. But he said what he started doing, he started hunting the inside part. And it got him in trouble because he wanted a hook. And then all of a sudden now, the Chris Carpenter 6-7 years ago can't get to this pitch where 80% plus of the big league pitches that comes out of a big leaguer hand is gonna be right there on the corner, okay? So what that does, what he's saying is that he was a one-dimensional pull hitter, is what he's really trying to say. I'll say that again in layman's terms. He was a one-dimensional hitter. That's why he haven't been the silver slugger guy that he was, or that three-time all-star guy that he was. He fell into the trap of the lifting the ball, launch angle thing, and he kind of now is battling for a spot in the big leagues now. So he was a one-dimensional pull hitter. That's what he said. Okay, that's not what I'm saying. That's not my diagnosis. That's exactly what he said, okay? So what he said he's gonna try to do now, which I preach and I tell all my kids here at first round training, is to eliminate the inside part of the plate. Why we wanna eliminate the inside part of the plate? Because the inside part of the plate for us, now we're gonna switch back around the righties, okay? And I'm just using point of contacts here, all right? This is what we make point of contact with a ball down the middle. This is where we make contact with the ball on the inside, okay? And this is where we make contact somewhere up in here on a ball on the outside. Okay, so excuse me right there. This is normally how it, you know, the point of contact look. All right, big league strike zone, you know, is from the knees, you know, I say to the belly button right there, okay? So just imagine these point of contacts at the height from your knee to your belly button. That's the big league strike zone, supposedly, okay? So he said that he started hunting balls in this area right here. So what that does is that eliminates you to drive the ball the other way. It eliminates you from being closed, okay? Being square. Right there. That's where we want to be when our foot gets down, okay? But if we're hunting a pitch in here, we're going to open it up a little bit, okay? Because we always favor our pull side anyway, because that's the natural way to go. It's the reason why our coach tells us to hit the ball the other way in the beginning of practice, is because going the other way is unnatural. Pulling the ball is natural. So we want to, in order for us to stay square to the baseball, or in other terms, I want you to stay closed, or stay on the ball, or be in a position to go directly to the baseball. All those different things are the same thing. In order for us to do that, we have to be looking for something on the outer half. Because anytime we look for something on the inner half, we are going to open up. Okay, and when we open up too soon, now we are really handicapped on the outside part of the plate. And that's exactly in the video what he said he's gonna get back to, as hunting the pitch out here, out over the plate. That's what every big league hitter like, out over the plate. Why? Because it allows us to get extended. It allows us to be free, all right? So that's a mistake. That's the pitch a big leaguer don't want to throw, a ball right down the middle, hip high, out over the plate. It's a mistake pitch. That's where you get hurt. Okay, so this is the ball that Carpenter wants to hunt this year, out over the plate, to stay square, to stay in that left center gap, because he's a left-hander. That's what he's trying to do. Okay,